day at the haunted house. I noticed that. I reckon I was right to think of fetching the little bags along." The money was soon in the bags, and the boys took it up to the cross rock. "Now let's fetch the guns and things," said Huck. "No, Huck, leave them there. They're just the tricks to have when you go to robbing. We'll keep them there all the time, and we'll hold our orgies there, too. It's an awful snug place for orgies."
"What's orgies?"
"I don't know, but robbers always have orgies, and of course we've got to have them, too. Come along, Huck. We've been in here a long time. It's getting late, I reckon. I'm hungry, too. We'll eat and smoke when we get to the skiff."
They presently emerged into the clump of sumac bushes, looked warily about, found the coast clear, and were soon lunching and smoking in the skiff. As the sun dipped toward the horizon, they pushed out and got under way. Tom skimmed up the shore through the long twilight, chatting cheerily with Huck, and landed shortly after dark.
"Now, Huck," said Tom, "we'll hide the money in the loft of the widow's woodshed, and I'll come up in the morning, and we'll count it and divide it, and then we'll hunt up a place out in the woods for it, where it will be safe. Just you lay quiet here and watch the stuff till I run up and hook Benny Taylor's little wagon. I won't be gone a minute."
He disappeared, and presently returned with the wagon, put the two small sacks into it, threw some old rags on top of them, and started off, dragging his cargo behind him. When the boys reached the Welshman's house, they stopped to rest. Just as they were about to move on, the Welshman stepped out and said,
"Hello, who's that?"
"Huck and Tom Sawyer."
"Good. Come along with me, boys. You are keeping everybody waiting. Here, hurry up, trot ahead. I'll haul the wagon for you. Why, it's not as light as it might be. Got bricks in it, or old metal?"
"Old metal," said Tom.
"I judge so. The boys in this town will take more trouble and fool away more time hunting up 6 bits worth of old iron to sell to the foundry than they would to make twice the money at regular work. But that's human nature. Hurry along, hurry along."
The boys wanted to know what the hurry was about.
"Never mind. You'll see when we get to the Widow Douglas's,"
Huck said with some apprehension.